So, hi everyone. Welcome to our webinar today. We're going to be talking about how you can land your dream job in creative industries. I'm Megha Jha. I'm the Research and Brand Development Officer at Band India. And I started my journey with writing as a student. Like back when I was in school, I used to write for my school newspaper. And then I knew that I wanted to pursue writing. So eventually I started, when I went to university, I've done my bachelor's in journalism and mass communication from Amity University, Mumbai. So at university, I started pursuing internships with brands like Penguin India, Juggernaut Books, Vogue Magazine, and more. I've also worked with DSSC Idea Labs, and I've worked with Bound also as an intern before I got into a full-time role. And I'm so glad all of you are here today. So we'll just get started with the presentation. If everyone can just mute themselves, that would be great. Is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, the first step to getting your dream job in creative industries is exploring your skills. How do you explore your skills? You need to understand your creative strengths and weaknesses. All of us have different strengths and weaknesses. I know I can write well. When I know I can write well, it allows me to explore career options which will complement my skills. So I can work as a copywriter, I can work as a content writer, I can also work in the magazine industry, I can work as a journalist. So when I know what my creative strengths are, it helps me identify which exact career option would be most to complement my... If I know my weaknesses, then I can automatically eliminate those out. So like, I'm not great with design language. So any career relating to art would be a no-go for me. And if you're at the school or university level, I would recommend that you join the, I'm sure you'll have a lot of clubs in your school or college. So I would recommend that you join those clubs and start seeing what you enjoy doing. So when I was in school, I joined my school newspaper as a writer. Then I eventually became an editor and an editor in chief. So it was pretty clear to me early on that writing is something I enjoy and it's something I'm good at. Then another way to explore your skills is to sign up for online classes. So when you sign up for different online classes or you spend more time researching about particular subjects, you understand what particular areas are up to your liking, what interests you, where you can build yourself further, where you can evolve and grow into a creative professional, in which exact craft or art or industry can be potential for growth. Yes, to new projects and opportunities. I started working at Radical, which is an digital platform, where they interview professionals from across industries. And that opportunity opened up to me through a former colleague. She reached out to me to ask if I have any friends who would be interested in internships. And I said, I would be interested in an internship. And I worked with her and I learned a lot. I learned copywriting, I learned brand development, I learned collaborations, I learned interviewing skills. So because I said yes to a project, it opened up more new avenues for me in terms of skills, in terms of building contacts with other professionals in the industry, in terms of adding more relevant work experience to my resume, as to new projects and opportunities. Even if it doesn't work out for you, it's always easier to step out of it than to find an opportunity to step in. So never say no to an opportunity without giving it a try first. then take up internships with organizations from diverse industries. Even though I knew I wanted to be a writer, I tried to, every summer I tried to sign up for an internship with an organization which is, while focused on writing, it diversifies the kind of work that they do. In my first year, I worked at a magazine. In my second year, I worked at two publishing houses. In my third year, I worked at an experiential marketing firm that works with food and beverage brands across industries. So that opened me up to a lot of potential, a lot of possibilities. The more diversely you work in terms of internship, the easier it will be for you to understand and locate which particular industry would suit you best for your job. It will help you navigate the career waters earlier rather than later. So I would recommend that for you. Then the second thing that you can do to land your dream job is to build your profile. So how do you build your profile? If you're starting early, if you're at like a school or university level, always helps to join clubs or work with internships. Like I said, you need to diversify your experience. The more experiences you get, the more you know what you don't like, and the closer it will take you towards what you do like. Not just about your likes or dislikes, you will also learn how you can develop new skills. You will learn which particular industries are more suitable for you. You will also develop new hobbies or inculcate new skills that might not be directly relevant to your job, but it will complement it in a secondary or a tertiary way. Then when you talk about building your profile, it's important to have your own. So like how you can do that, one of the ways which I would recommend is building your personal website. So there are a lot of free website building tools like Wix and WordPress. You can always set up your personal website where you talk about yourself. You highlight your skills. You highlight your projects. If you're a writer, you would want to have a portfolio of the work that gets published. If you are an author, you would want to display your books that have been published or essentially collaborates all of your interests, all of your work into a common space which can be easily accessed by potential recruiters. It can be accessed by people on social media, and a lot of your opportunities might come your way through a website like this. The third way that you can build your portfolio is through professional social media accounts. So when I say social media, I'm majorly going to emphasize on having a professional Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram account. So LinkedIn, when you create these accounts, one thing that you should keep in mind is that your bio should clearly emphasize on your key skills. So my bio on Instagram would say copywriter, editor, brand builder, my expertise, areas of expertise. So similarly on LinkedIn, so when you make a portfolio on LinkedIn, it's essential to have your bio there. When recruiters are looking at your profile, they need to know what your strengths are. They need to know what skills you have. They need to know what you offer, that what you can bring on board for their organization. A blank bio, even if you've added your resume and experiences below, because people might not scroll below your name, below your bio line. So it's important to put everything in the most concise and attractive manner right there so that people don't have to scroll. It should catch their attention immediately. The fourth way that you can build your portfolio is through freelancing or taking a project. like I said, so I noticed that some of you are professionals who are looking to switch your careers. So while you are working at your current job or in your current industry, a great way to switch your career would be to take up freelancing project, freelance opportunities or projects on a part-time basis so that you can build a portfolio which is relevant for your dream industry. You can build a resume which is more relevant to your dream industry than your current resume. One of the ways where how you can look up freelancing opportunities and projects is there are a lot of online resources available. Like there are websites that offer direct opportunities for freelancing, and including Bound, like we also work with freelancers, so you can always write to us. You can search other web communities and websites where you can find projects and post updates. Even Facebook has a lot of groups where you can find freelance content writing opportunities. So you can always check that out. Then the fifth way is your resume. So your resume needs to am I clear to everyone? There's someone who's saying I'm not audible.
Yes, Megha, you're clear.
Okay, yeah, sorry. So your resume needs to be on point. There are recruiters, there are companies, there are people sitting behind screens. When you write to them, they are receiving emails every day. They're receiving hundreds of emails every day. What makes you stand out is a resume that is crisp, it's concise, and it's to the point so that it immediately stands out. It reflects your best qualities. It reflects your skills. It reflects your experience. And I'm going to tell you more about that. So when you're building a resume, try not to go for like fancy designs. Recruiters really don't care much for design language. Unless you're, of course, entering the design industry, you want to become a graphic designer. So that then you can get a little creative. But even simple resume, even the simplest of resumes work very well if they're well collated. So your resume should always start with your name. Then it should follow your contact details, your email ID and your phone number. You do not need to add any more contact details. Like you just need to add your one main email ID and one phone number. The third thing on your resume, right below your contact details, should be your qualifications. So you can obviously panel this out. There are different formats for resumes available online, on Word, on MS Word, on Word Docs, on Google Docs. So you can always play around with the formats, but your qualifications should be clearly listed out. The school and university that you attended, the years that you attended it during, and the marks that you scored. If you like, you can also talk more about your university studies. So when I studied journalism and mass communication, I also studied advertising, marketing, corporate communication. And if I feel that I need to highlight those learning experiences for a particular job, I would recommend that you add them under your university name. And then you can also, then you have to talk about your skills. So when I talk about my skills as a writer, I have to talk about whether I'm a copywriter, whether I'm a content writer, whether I'm a feature writer, whether I'm an editor. So there are a certain significant amount of skills that I have developed over time. So when I put together my resume, those skills should be separately highlighted on that. Your education, your work experience don't automatically always reflect what skills you possess. So make sure that you highlight your skills in a separate column and keep them short, keep them to a word or two. So don't try to make them into proper sentences. It's not required. You can just add them a word or two on your resume. The next is your work experience. So even in your qualifications and in your work experience, you should always write it from the newest to the oldest. So the recruiter should be able to look at your freshest and latest work experience or latest educational qualification. And your work experience section should mention your title, the work duration, how long you worked there, and your responsibilities. The responsibilities you undertook while you were working there under a certain role. So while I'm working as a content writer at an organization, I will probably be working with writing blog articles for their website. I will probably write captions for their Instagram posts, and I will write their newsletter. So all of those things you need to highlight under your work experience in the most crisp manner, but also ensure that you highlight all the important aspects of what you did at a particular organization. Then next, you can add your additional qualifications. So if you take courses on Coursera, or if you take online courses which have added to your skills, which have helped you develop skills or give more credential to your skills. So if, say, today I want to go and become an editor, it would be really great if I can say that I have attended a course on publishing and editing with Bound, with an experienced editor. That adds more value to what my claims are about my skills. So having qualifications is always a plus, and make sure that you always mention them on your resume. Then you should always add, if you have won any awards that are related to your professional work experience, like say I have won certain awards for writing, or if you have been published in some major publications, you can always mention that here. So that will also work towards setting you apart from everyone else who's applying. Whenever you're putting together your resume, ensure that you are not copy pasting the same resume for each job. Your resume needs to be edited, and you know, like, it needs to be restructured according to every particular job, because every job has different requirements. It requires different skills. Every company is different, and you need to always edit and reevaluate what your resume looks like for every new job when you apply. So how do you land your dream company? The first way, and the most important way, when you're reaching out to companies, you need to write effective cover letters. I have personally come across emails for recruitment emails where people have attached their resume. It simply says, "Hi, please find my resume attached below for a job." Nobody is going to read that. Nobody will open it. So you need to go beyond that simple attaching your resume, and you need to add a proper constructive cover letter which draws the attention of the reader within seconds. You need to understand that these recruiters are busy people. They go through hundreds of emails every day. So you need to make their job easier, and making their job easier adds brownie points to your experience with that particular organization. Because if you make their job easier, it's quicker for them to read, it's quicker for them to pick you up. That sets you apart from other candidates instantly. So your email subject should always say job. If you're applying for a job, it should say job application, colon, and then insert the title you're applying, the job title you're applying for. If you're applying for an internship, similarly, if I want to apply for the position of a content writer at Bound, I will say job application, colon, content writer. If I want to apply for an internship at Bound, I will say internship application, editorial intern. So try to be as precise as you can. Because hi or hello or long email subjects, will not lead to people opening them. Recruiters need immediately, if I read something like that, I will open it. And if I'm interested in hiring people, or if I'm not, sometimes recruiters save these resumes for later reference whenever they are hiring. So try to be as precise as you can. Then when you start writing your cover letter, it should simply say your name, about which position you're writing for. It should talk about your qualification in the second line. It should talk about your expertise in the third line. So if I'm applying for a job, I would say I have over 3 years of experience in content writing or writing. So, and I have worked with this company in the past. Then you will talk, and don't write all the companies that you have worked with. Try to highlight the best aspects of your resume, of your work experience in this cover letter, because this is what leads them to open your resume even. This is what they read before they go down to download or click your resume open. This has to attract them. But mention why you wish to work with them. It's always a good idea to go back and do some research on the company that you're applying to. Invest some time in understanding what they do. Invest some time in learning their brand language, their brand identity, and understanding what exactly they would look for in an employee. What value can you bring to their company? So when you're writing your cover letter, it's always a good idea to mention that, you know, I wish to work with you to bring so and so. I feel that I can bring this and this to your organization. So when I wrote to Bound, I told them that I can bring my experience in writing and my experience in previous experience in working with brands and collaborations to your organization. And that always helps, because people need to know why they should even hire you. And before they open your resume, you're telling them that. So it's always a great idea to be a step ahead of your recruiters, so that you are always already separate and already highlighted amongst a sea of resumes. Then, as you can read, you can simply say, I'm attaching my resume in this mail for your reference. Looking forward to hearing from you. Thank you for your time and consideration. Even if they don't hire you, they'll actually spend time in reading that email. So it's always polite and to thank them for their time. And then you can simply say regards and add your name. And since you're already adding your contact details to the resume, I don't feel it's necessary. But if you like, you can add your phone number to the cover letter as well. So now, that was about writing effective cover letters. And that is, you'll write that email when you know what you want to do and where you're applying. But what do you do when you are unsure about which company you want to apply to? Let's say I'm a writer, but I don't know which company I want to work with. There's so many magazines, there's so many publishing houses, there's so many digital platforms. I don't know what I want to do. So spend some time researching companies on LinkedIn, researching, going to their websites, studying them, going to Instagram and studying them. I landed my internship at DSSC Ideas Lab, which I already told you is a F&B experiential marketing company, which works with food and beverage brands. And what I started following them on Instagram, and I was very attracted to their copywriting, and I really loved it. So I wanted to learn from that, and I wanted to work with a brand that writes such brilliant, engaging, snappy copies. So I wrote to them and I got an internship, and I learned so much more than copywriting there. So when you're looking at Instagram, even when you're just scrolling through it in the evening, during the day, even if it's just for fun, try to identify if there is some brand that makes you laugh, if there's a brand whose products you love. Like, I would love to write for Arata because I love their hair products. And it's as simple as that. Identify these companies, because there are certain traditional companies that you can always apply to. But in my experience, it is always a good idea to diversify your work pool of choices, because it will in turn eventually lead you to greater learning experiences. So when you want to land your dream job at a company, always reach out to people rather than company inboxes. I know most companies have email IDs given on their website where, you know, they say contact email ID, and this is a common email ID that is there on their website. But this is where you need to step in and separate yourself from the crowd. Everyone will be writing to that email ID. So you can imagine how full that email ID must be at the end of the day. And it's very easy to lose your email in a pool of emails, which are a mixed bunch. There are also recruitment emails. There are other work emails. So what I mean by reaching out to people rather than company inboxes is that almost all companies have a LinkedIn profile where you can see their employees. So, and a lot of these employees have provided their email addresses online. And if not, you can spend some time doing some research. So a lot of companies have common work emails. So it will say, let's say megha@boundindia.com. So if you can identify something like that, and then you can identify, like, let's say I identify an editor at Penguin, and I want to work at Penguin, I would rather write an email to that editor instead of sending it to Penguin's slush file. Because Penguin Randomize India is a huge organization, and they receive emails, thousands and thousands of emails every day. So they're not going to be checking their email every day. So you would rather want to be in an actual person's inbox over writing to a company email, because you never know if that's even being checked. But if you write to a person, you have a higher rate of getting a response from them, of your resume being noticed, of your email being open. So try to do that as much as you can. Then the fourth point is to enter competitive workplaces through internships. As you can imagine, there are a lot of big companies that we aspire to work with, but they are very competitive. You know, getting a break in a company like that, it's very difficult. So if you're a fresher, you can always go back and start as an intern. And once you have shown, and when you're working as an intern at a company, don't take it as your day-to-day job. It's going to end in 2 months. You never have to see them again. Always take it as an opportunity to build your relationship with the company, build your relationship with its employees, to show them what you can do, to go the extra mile. As an intern, you're given only a certain specific amount of work. But if you try to go the extra mile with the work that you're doing with them, they will always notice, they will always remember it. So when you ask them for a job, it will be a much easier step than an outside recruitment or than applying to them without having worked with them. And the fifth point is focus on your learnings. Like I said, you must diversify your work experiences as much as you can. And when you do that, you learn more and more things. So always try to, stay open to new opportunities, to new avenues, and keep your eyes and ears and mind open, because every place you work will teach you something. So try to make the most of that learning and absorb that, so that when you move on to the next workplace, you are already level above where you were in your last job. So that's it for today. If you guys have any questions, you can ask me. And if you, like someone I just saw in the chat box, said that it's very difficult to get freelance assignments when starting out. So for that, I would like to tell you that Bound is organizing a class for freelancers. It's called How to Become a Freelance Writer, Ideate, Pitch and Publish with Anubhuti Krishna, who is an expert and a revered freelance food and travel writer. If you want, you can also watch our interview with her on our IGTV. And like I said, you constantly need to expand your skills, and especially if you're trying to transfer from one industry to another, it's always a good idea to take up as many online classes as you can. Try to build your skills as much as you can. It will always help you grow and expand your avenues. I will add the link in the chat box so that you can go and check out these classes for yourself.